Yo, this is Deontay the Bronze Bummer Wilder, heavyweight champion of the world, and you're watching Real Fans Real Talk.
Face facts, what up?
RealFansRealTalk.com, where Arthur Thomas, Trip Young, and intern Tom, for the white and black fans, Asia to Manhattan. I get all my facts from my bro, Mark the Stats Man. If you're not tuned in, I recommend a CAT scan. And if your brain checks out, then you deserve a backhand. Sports, gossip, all the hot topics. RealFansRealTalk.com got it. They got the hottest bloggers.
Did Jeremy Lin hurt?
We'll log on to the site and you can hear it from them first. I'm talking about the latest. I'm talking about the greatest. Go check out the archives. Even tell a neighbor. Tell a Bobby sent ya. From spring to winter. Tuning in should be the only thing on your agenda. Certified cosign. You know what I'm about, son. RealFansRealTalk.com. I'm out. One. Real fans. Real talk. Real fans. Real talk. RealFansRealTalk.com. RealFansRealTalk.com. Real fans. Real talk. Real fans. Real talk. RealFansRealTalk.com. RealFansRealTalk.com.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to another live episode of Real Fans Real Talk. I'm Mark the Statman Skevich. We got a great show lined up for you tonight. We got the cast of A Piece of Me, the movie, which is opening soon. We got a lot of sports talk to talk about. I hope nobody recorded me before we went live and heard some of the things that I was saying off camera, like certain people do out there in the professional, or should I say, supposed to be professional world, but we'll get into that.
Okay, I'm not gonna let your secrets out of the bag. You say, all right, we're not gonna do what the Lakers did, all right?
Exactly. We're not D'Angelo Russell. We do keep things the things that are meant to be private are kept private, ladies and gentlemen. But before we get into that and more sports topics and the cast of The Piece of Me, let me introduce my partner in the Real Fans Real Talk movement, my co-host, the one and only Trip Young. What's going on, Trip?
What's going on? Hold on. Wait. My tape deck is... All right, we good. I just wanted to make sure everything was copacetic. The tape deck is off. I'm not recording right now.
Well, but someone else is recording.
Oh, someone else is...
I hope somebody else is recording.
Well, in the booth, yeah, you know. But, it's definitely been a good week. If y'all noticed, the set is full today. We got a whole lot of people. We got more. I feel like we brought the entire cast. Most people might get one or two. We was actually able to get almost the entire cast of the A Piece of Me movie. Plus, we got the director, Jermaine Smith, my big bro. He's going to be in here a little bit later. It was just so many. We couldn't fit everybody on the set at one time. So we had to rotate and swap people in and out. But it's going to be a good show. And I'm sure they got a lot to talk about with this movie, because the premiere is going to be next Thursday, right here in Brooklyn. So if you don't have your tickets, you better rush right now. Get online, get them tickets. The Eventbrite page is up. When Jay comes on the set, he'll give you guys all the information for anybody who doesn't have. I don't know why you wouldn't have your tickets already. Let me just start by saying that if you don't got your tickets already, you might want to jump in the lake, because you're missing out on a great experience right now. The movie, I seen the trailer. I seen little snippets here and there. And we got my man Bryce Jr. What's going on, man? How you feeling today, man? What's going on, all right? You know, so we just going to jump into it. Statman, what you got for us, man?
Well, first, the sports news, but we talked about the unprofessionalism out there with D'Angelo Russell. Now he has to play with them, and, of course, you have forwards bringing up the ball, not wanting to pass it to him. He's over there with his hands out like, hey, it's my job. I'm supposed to bring up the ball, but nobody want any part of that.
They wouldn't even sit with him at the lunch tables. I heard through the grapevine, Lou Williams got up from the table as he was about to sit down. So it was real, you know, junior high school Mean Girls. You remember the movie Mean Girls? Mm-hmm. It's kind of like that. Like, they have completely isolated D'Angelo Russell. Now, I read earlier, now I don't know if this is true, but I heard that Nicki Minaj might be involved in this whole scandal. She had her little beef with Iggy Azalea, so she might have put the call in to D'Angelo Russell and got him to, you know, leak that stuff. You know, he said he didn't. But at the same time, I don't know why you would even record something like that anyway. He definitely broke guy code with that one. You don't record another play. You don't even record none of your boys talking about their indiscretions. You shouldn't be having indiscretions, though, fellas. Let me say that. I don't want the ladies to be mad at me. You should not be having those kind of indiscretions. But if you are, you should not be taping them with your fellow teammates and then letting them get leaked. So that's what's going on.
That's in the history of the Lakers. Yep. Well, Kobe Bryant did that to Shaq.
Don't have a mic on you.
Yeah, so you got it. Well, hold on. pass on the mic on that one. We got a little.
Nah, that's in the history of the Lakers, because Kobe Bryant did that to Shaq.
He most. You know what? And I'm glad that you mentioned that because I go back and forth with Laker fans about this all the time because they're in denial about the fact that Kobe threw Shaq under the bus for
that was corny.
At all. You know, he said, I believe the line was, I should have just paid him off like Shaq did. So you are right about that. It is definitely, you know, that is a Laker thing, you know, snitching and dropping dime on your teammates. But, I just don't understand why. I mean, he's young, so he's a kid. He's still, 19 years old, so I don't know why.
That generation is crazy. So they do stuff that is just not understandable.
And hold on,
it also just has to do with being young because you got, 20 years old. Yeah. Kobe was young when he did it.
Yeah, he was. Right.
You know, and there's the immaturity. You see that with Johnny Football, Johnny Manziel and everything, just messing things up, acting immaturely. I mean, it's a joke for him, but then the aftermath, the punishment for recording something like that is real. And he realized he screwed up. But it isn't something that we're just going to throw under the bus, under the rug here, sweep under the rug. I mean, it's something that affects the man's life, his relationship with his would-be fiancé. Exactly. Who knows if that's going to go down
that,
now.
Man, you might have a chance. You might be able to work your way
I mean,
up
that's
there.
The good thing out of it. You know,
exactly.
Me and Iggy could probably work something out now.
Exactly.
But.
You know what? She would be interested, too.
See, there you go.
I appreciate that.
Hold on, while you got the mic over there, just introduce yourself first.
All right, how you doing? My name is Zay Diggs.
And just tell everybody who you play in the movie.
I play Baby Boy in the movie A Piece of Me. Y'all should go out there and see it April 7th. We got the premiere coming. Check that out.
Everybody's going to be there. Everybody, you ain't got to worry about that because I heard that the tickets is almost gone. So everybody's coming out.
Oh, yeah, it's almost sold out.
It's almost sold out. So you might want to put a pre-order on your popcorn now because you know how it gets. When the theater get crowded, you don't want to get the leftover toaster leavings of the popcorn. You want to get your fresh bucket. So be there on time. Hold up. Don't come late because I know sometimes y'all like to stroll in. Don't do that.
Don't be on CPT.
Yeah, don't do that, man, because the previews is going to be dope. They got a lot of special things going on that night. So you're going to want to be – don't even be on time. Be early. Be 10 minutes early, and then you're going to be – because it's going to be a line. You know, y'all don't want to deal with all the lines.
You don't want them seats in the front where you got to strain your neck in the front.
Exactly.
And you got to look up at the screen the whole time. You don't want those seats.
Exactly.
So get there on
time.
I've
been there before. You don't want to do that. You want to get a nice, cozy seat, maybe in the middle section somewhere, or maybe get the end seat because you don't want people stepping over you by the time, you know, for all the latecomers that come in and whatnot. But I'm going to go back on this side over here. Kim?
Yeah.
Could you tell them in the movie who you playing?
My name is Kimberly Medina Courts, and I am playing Darlene King, who is the oldest sister of the family. And, y'all got to come out and see this film. It's really, really a good film, and I think that everybody is going to enjoy it, I swear. And here is someone I would like to introduce, so I'll let him introduce himself.
My main man.
Yeah.
My name is Jaden Ellis, and in the movie I'm playing as Kid Bryce.
You did that real smooth, too. I like how you did that real smooth, you know, and I'm looking forward to see your character in this movie, little man, because you know we support the kids wholeheartedly on Real Fans, Real Talk, you know, and I'm proud that you was able to get up in the movie. You did your thing. In the trailer, I seen a lot of stuff, so I'm waiting to see what's going on. What was the most challenging part about this for you? Or was it everything was just easy, it just happened and you just got it? Did it take you long to memorize your lines or nothing?
Yeah, it was kind of hard.
It was hard memorizing those lines?
Mm-hmm.
Did you have fun though shooting the movie?
Yeah.
Who's your favorite character? Other than yourself.
I'm about to put myself. I didn't even see the trailer yet.
Well, what
with
do you...
the doctor.
Doctor? Steve, that's you over there? Oh, man. Steve is our resident NHL expert on the set. So, Steve, hold on. Who's your team?
Rangers.
All right, he's okay.
Yeah, he's
I
good.
Approve.
He's good to go. He's good to go. You can come back anytime you want. Talk hockey, talk sports. You're good. You're riding with us right now. That's always a bonus.
Now, the Rangers are always have always been a contender the past like 3 years or so. Do you think that this is the year?
I don't know. I mean, this has definitely been, I think, Lundqvist's weakest year. But, I mean, they need more defense. Everyone thinks their defense is pretty good, but this year I don't know what's the matter. I think they're going to make the playoffs.
Yeah.
But the fact that if they play Pittsburgh, I don't know. They can't beat Pittsburgh.
What about the Capitals?
Caps choke every year.
They tend to match up somewhat okay with them.
Yeah.
But,
I mean, Caps are going to choke either way. I mean, I don't know if the Rangers will be the team to beat them, but the Caps are definitely, they're not going to.
Well, the way they're seeded 1 and 2, somebody else might knock them off before they even get to that point. But what's your role in the movie, and how did you get involved with the Piece of Me movie?
Oh, I played the doctor, Dr. Johnson, and I actually used to work with Jermaine in retail. And it was, you know, and he, you know, he knew I was an actor, and he told me about he was writing this film. And, you know, I heard a lot about it, and he let me audition for it, and, you know, he called me, and he liked the way I read the part, and, you know, went from there. And, I mean, he's really passionate about the film. He always talked about it, and I wanted to be a part of it, so.
I'm surprised I wasn't casted for the role. I'm a little upset about that, but it's okay. We'll let it go. I'm sure you did a good job. I'll be there at the premiere to see, you know, how well all of you guys did. I'm looking forward to it.
Too, so it's all good.
I mean, yeah, so that makes it even better then. At least the Rangers are representing on set. But it's great to see the kid in the movie as well, Jaden. And, you know, maybe he'll be one of those superstars that you see in the future, all grown up and everything. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, you had Drew Barrymore as a kid in the E.T. movie and stuff. And then you see her all grown up, and then you got kids growing up, and then, like, you look back, this was his first role, and then he's a superstar. Yep. And don't forget about Real Fans Real Talk when you're big time, though, okay?
Now, how was it for you? Did you have homework during the tapings? Like, did you have to go home first, do your homework, and then come back to the set, or what was that like?
No, I came from school and then did my homework. And then at, like, 7 o'clock, I went to Jermaine, and then he started filming me.
And you're still doing good in school? Yeah, come on, man. That's what I'm talking about. You got to keep them grades up if you want to be in the movies. That's a beautiful thing, you know. Now, all right, Kim, your character.
Uh-huh.
All right. You are...
Darlene King.
Yeah. All right. Now, first of all, you guys have only seen the trailer, but you haven't seen any of the extra clips or anything, so this is all going to be a surprise.
This is all new to us. Yep. So, this is all new to us. We have put our heart into this film, like... Yeah. It's touching on some deep subjects, touchy subjects, especially within the African American community and the Latino community, with certain subjects that are not spoken about a lot of times, you know, like incest within families and whatnot. So it's really deep. It gets really deep. So, you know. We had a tough time on set, you know, getting to those high points and those low points, but it was a really great adventure.
How did you prepare yourself for the role?
Well, Darlene is a lot like me in ways. She is the strong, tough sister. I was the older sister, and in real life, Kim is the only child, so I didn't know what it was like growing up having to lead, you know, my sisters and brothers, but at the same time, my preparation came a lot from theater, being able, because I have to hit some moments in this film, so theater has always been a base for me, and that was, you know, a good place to be able to tap into. Yeah, so I'm really hoping everybody comes out to see it. It's going to be a real good film, really good film.
Definitely.
Yeah.
And how did you get involved with the film?
Audition. I'm a full-time actress, so, you know, once I see something that has castings involved, I send my headshot and resume, and I show up to the auditions. And I had worked with Zay before. We've worked on other films together, and we keep each other abreast of different things that's going on. So, you know, once we're in this community, we're almost like family. Nice. And it just so happens that he's my brother in this film. So, you know, to have to work with some, yep. And outside of work, he my brother too.
That's right.
So do y'all, you know, y'all, when y'all speak to each other now, even still, hey, what's up, sis? What's up, bro?
Yes, I call him baby.
Definitely.
Bro.
Definitely.
I do,
baby boy stuck with me.
Yeah.
Jermaine, I gotta thank you for life for that.
Yeah.
Baby boy stuck with me. But you know, definitely the acting world is but so big, and the same people constantly bump into the same circle. So, you know, I seen everybody on the circle, like even the lead character, Bryce. We audition against each other. Like, yeah. That's how crazy it is. But a funny story with that is, he was supposed to be Baby Boy originally. I auditioned for the movie and I didn't get it. But, you know, God got a plan. Like, what's meant to be is going to happen. Yep. So I wound up getting the role as Baby Boy. I connected with Jermaine. He reached out to me. He said, you know, I liked you in the audition. And, you know, some people wasn't sold on you, but I know you could do it. So yeah. He believed in me, and that's what made me really want to be a part of the movie. So once he had the belief in me, I was like, you know what? That's it. I'm all in. And, you know, we created a powerful film. Yeah. Like, it's going to change.
To my main man, Tim Nate. Oh, that's right. We didn't get a chance to let y'all know last time when he was on the show with us that was him in that Super Bowl commercial. Since he's not here, we letting y'all know at home that was Tim Nato from that Tostitos Super Bowl commercial a little bit over a year ago. Shout out to DeVal. He wanted to be here tonight. He couldn't be here tonight, but we're going to see him next week at the premiere anyway. So, but much love, man.
Word, that's a big bro right there. Even though I don't really like him too much.
Well, shots cool. Fired out there.
Cool guy in real life, but in the movie.
Yeah, I got you. Oh,
okay, all right.
Yeah, you know? But it definitely was a great experience. You know, Jermaine he's very professional, and he makes sure his actors are taken care of. So I would work with him anytime again. Mm. Like, people should support this movie because a lot of people, they don't understand the importance of support.
Yeah.
You know?
Definitely understand that.
And people should just partake in this film because it's one of those movies that is going to change the game. We just need people to see it. So April 7th, y'all better come out. Y'all better be there.
We Linden got my man Cineplex.
Right here. Right. He steals the film. This guy's dope. You know, it's a lot of dope actors in the movie that's going to come up in New York, and we're all trying to advance ourselves. So I should check it out.
So let's really quick, if you guys do have Instagram, let's go around, and then we're going to jump into the trailer once you guys give your Instagram to the people at home.
Yes, on Instagram, I am Ladybug Courts. That's LadyBugCourts.
Don't look for his Instagram, all right? You don't need to know his Instagram. He's a superstar. All right, just look for his star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame in about 20 years. That's all.
That's what's up. My Instagram is Diggs_Town.
And then, Steve, we just gave you one earlier today.
It's not official.
It's not official yet, but, you know.
What is it?
We got what was at NHL?
Knowledge. NHL knowledge, yeah.
We just made that up on the spot.
That's not a real one. Don't that might be more. Taken already. And if it's not taken already, it is by somebody over there right now.
But we are going to really quick, we're going to jump into the trailer because we want you guys to see some of what these guys have done on set before next Thursday when we are all at the premiere of A Piece of Me, the movie.
So there won't be a live episode of Real Fans, Real Talk next week. Yeah, that's how big this is, ladies and gentlemen. But we've been talking about the trailer a lot. Next week we'll have, for you fans out there, we'll have the Bowling for Peace episode with a lot of great interviews. So still tune in next week to Real Fans Real Talk. Great episode, but we will be in the building for the premiere. But for those of you, we've been talking about the movie. Let's roll that trailer for you.
So I need you guys. No, that's fine. I was gonna say to put it down.
You gonna stop rushing.
It's been on my mind all day.
Well, you need to hurry up.
What will we do? What will I say?
Baby boy, why would you have your girlfriend meet the family at such a time as this?
Honestly, look, nobody knew Daddy would be sick. We booked our tickets weeks ago.
You getting small with me, boy?
No, I'm not. Look, Denise offered to buy the ticket. I took it.
So you with her for her paper? That's my nephew.
No,
that's my
I'm
boy.
Not. I wanted her to meet my family for the first time.
And you?
Yo, no disrespect, my boy, but my marriage ain't up for discussion.
Bryce. Maxine is a good woman.
I know.
You actually like somebody? You actually like your lips the size they are?
Look, all I'm saying is, me and Max be going through whatever it is.
Just take me to the hospital to see my brother. That's all I need you to do. Do that.
Watch out, watch out.
I thought we were going to have...
All right, there we go. That's it. That's the last one. You want me to play the family on three video? Let's check some more.
These hips.
Yeah. All right, the set is a little bit different now here on Real Fans Real Talk. Got to change it up a little bit. We are back live with the cast of the Piece of Me movie. The premiere is next Thursday, April 7th. Make sure you're in the building. Real Fans Real Talk will be in the building. The cast will be in the building. I think there's a few tickets left, and we'll let you know how to buy your tickets with the one and only Jay, Jermaine.
Yes. The director,
thank you.
The creator. Welcome, writer, director, producer, cameraman, actor.
You wear many hats.
Mailman.
You shouldn't wear is that Philadelphia Flyers.
Oh, yeah. Man. I grabbed something to match the shoes, man. There's not too many hats go with orange shoes. So.
It's all good. Yeah, you got that one. You got that.
It's for style reasons.
Look, they
only.
Say you on TV, stand out, right?
Yeah. Okay. you stand out amongst the bunch of Rangers fans, that's for sure.
It's old fashioned. It's old fashioned.
I know.
I just worked at the NHL store with Steve.
Okay.
And so to compound that real quick, I was working there and I talked about the script through a lot of characters, a lot of people. And this gentleman moved to New York to chase his dream. You know what I mean? So if any way I could be a help and cast, even if he probably would have stunk up the audition, I would have gave him a shot. Anybody can make a move and chase their dream, you know, where you got to get behind them and support them. But he did his thing in auditions and he earned the spot. And plus, you know, we needed a little offset all the caramel we had on set. So we had to bring Steve in. We had to bring Leonardo in to do his thing. But he did his thing.
Next time you need that, I'm available.
Yeah, I got you.
I take up a lot of space, too.
Steve, you hear that? He coming for you in the sequel. We're going to boost the staff up. So I definitely
I'm his older brother.
There you go. That's Dr. Johnson.
Yeah. First of all, man, welcome to the show. And I got to let the people at home know this. You know, if you guys don't know, this man gave me my start in radio. I don't want to say how long ago it was because they don't need to know how old we getting.
It was 2010.
Come on, you got to cut out the bag like that. But he definitely, you know, we were on the jeveryday.com. It was an internet radio station, and he gave me my start. So, you know, anytime, you know, Jay is doing something, I'm always going to support him and make a push for it. You know, we worked together on a couple of projects. Yes, and we had a web series that we, you know, I helped him shoot. So, you know, anything he's doing. So I'm actually excited that this movie is done. I'm ready to hit the theaters and go see it because you might be one of the hardest working people. I mean, I'm talking about you got radio, you got books. Mm-hmm. You got web series, you got movies, you got the stage plays. What don't you do?
Well, I have to fall back on the perfume.
Oh, my goodness. Come
the
on,
ladies
man.
Fragrance. I had a ladies fragrance for a minute. I mean, when you're building a brand, you got to know your lane.
Yeah.
You know, ladies listening to the radio show, ladies came to the stage play. Mm-hmm. And there was a point where we hit a recession, and people weren't coming out to the plays like they used to. You know, so I wanted to keep the brand going.
Yeah.
And I decided to create something that was recession-proof. You know, women always gonna want to smell good.
Yeah.
You know, I didn't want to put out an alcohol brand because I couldn't push that at my. You know, alcohol really don't go bad too tough. So when you think of recession, there's certain things that people are gonna always need.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So they might not always need Pampers because you can create a diaper.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So there's certain things if we down our last dollar, you know, people gonna shop for certain things. So I made a fragrance to get me over between the plays, the radio, and the books.
And then, but now we here at this movie. And the movie is from the book.
Yes.
When did you say, all right, you know what? Everybody done read the book, but I need them to see the visuals and say, all right, I'm ready to do this movie.
Well, it hit me once the book really took off, and I was really trying to get this message across America and around the world. Mm-hmm. And that jumps back to the play. The play, we traveled with 15 people every time we went out. And it got to a point financially I couldn't keep carrying 15 people across America or the East Coast. I can get a book across America quicker than I can get 15 people, you know. So naturally, I progressed to the book, and the book, you know, did what it did. And I said, you know what, I believe this thing could be a film. You know, if it had close to 100 people turning life over to God through a play, and getting countless emails from the book doing spiritual and inspirational things to people, what could it do as a film? You know, so if it was done right, you know, I felt it took off. You know, so I've sent it to friends, Darren Grant, who directed Diary of a Mad Black Woman for Tyler Perry. I sat with a guy, Craig T. Williams, and we went through the script, and I got it from 174 pages to about 93.
Okay.
Well, I was happy, so, and just called some friends and said, look, I want to host some auditions. I got this role for you. Just got to knock it out. Mm-hmm. And, you know, we're here today.
And one thing I noticed, too, is because I know you mentioned Diary of a Mad Black Woman, you know, Tyler Perry, who also... He cast a lot of his people that were in the stage plays before he started doing the movies. He brought them over into the movies. And I know you have Martinique over here, who was also in the play. It was in Cooking in Yesterday's Grease, which was one of your other plays.
Yep.
And now she's in the movie as well. She was also in the web series as Uncle Johnny. So she was also, you know, in the web series as well. So I think that's dope. And then I guess, you know, it was just, when you know, y'all like the dynamic duo. Y'all just teamed back up and said, let's rock and roll. Is that's how it all went down?
Well, actually, you know, I've known Jermaine for a really long time, like you said. Mm-hmm. And when I first met him, I wasn't even intending on being in any type of programming or anything like that. I was actually coming to see one of his plays, and it was one of his cast members that was in the play, Stephen Strickland, that convinced me to come see the play at the time, which was called A Piece of Me.
Yeah.
And I had given up on acting, and I just wanted to just relax. Mm-hmm. I had lost my father the year before, and I just wasn't really trying to do anything. But I went to the play because of Stephen. And I watched it, and I'm telling you, the play, not only did it make me get back my love for acting, but it healed me, like for me to come out and go back out.
Yeah.
So from that point right there, I was going to always, if Jermaine has something going on, I'm there. Because, you know, without him, I wouldn't have been back in the stage. Yeah. I wouldn't have been doing all these things. And I'm just thankful, because look at God. Yes.
Martinique did Everyday Radio as well.
Yes,
too.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
You know, so I appreciate you guys for coming through and holding it down.
Yeah, so this is the team. We still here, you know.
Yeah.
We still pushing on. And I'm excited. Tell us about your character in the movie.
Oh, sure. In A Piece of Me, the movie. You know, it was a play, right? Did y'all know it was a novel too?
Yep.
And now it's the movie.
Exactly.
Well, in this particular movie, I play the homeless woman. And her name is Christine. And I'm just I had so much fun playing her both on stage and in film. Mm-hmm. Because I just think that she's a part of the inspiration for the film.
Yeah.
So I'm having a good time, you know, dressing down, because you can't rely on your pretty all your life. You have to be able to do roles that might have you gritty and things like that. This pretty stuff don't last long. So if you're not gonna put on makeup and do all the things that you need to do, y'all know it was me. Maybe I didn't recognize me, but it was me.
Listen, that's just good acting. That's
right.
And shout out to the makeup artist.
Exactly.
The makeup artist.
I'm having a great time. And working with all these people, oh my God, this queen right here, she just embraced me, and I'm just so thankful. The whole cast is so wonderful. And this brother right here, oh my God, he's doing so many big things, and I'm just thankful to be a part of this production.
Family now.
Yes. We Camily. Camily, cast family. Listen, copywriting that.
is the sequel on the way? Are you writing the sequel right now?
Well, sitting in post-production, I saw a lot of different ways that I can take it, and I want to go with it, you know what I mean? But I don't want to, you know, get past this one. You know, I want the world to see this, because I want to enjoy it, because there's so much going on in here that we don't discuss, like they were saying earlier. Mm-hmm. You know, we have an abortion clinic scene. You know, there's a wife that can't have children. You know, there's, as they discussed earlier, incest. As you see in the trailer, there's some stern discipline.
Yeah.
And how Bryce, the main character, talks to his wife. You know what I mean? So there's a lot of things that we're touching with this thing. So it's amazing. And people brought so much to the character that I didn't write.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's one thing to write the alphabet, but somebody has to read it. It's one thing to write a melody, but somebody got to sing it.
They really brought it to life.
They took Baby Boy and ran with it. You know what I mean? He brought some things to it that I didn't see it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And he really took it and just ran. You know, Kimberly to my left, she just went somewhere. You know, mm-hmm. I mean, she tapped into his own. When she sent me her her information on her YouTube, I was like, girl, you got to come out and audition. You know, she read for one role, and I was like, Could you go back out there and read this other role? Because this is better for you.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because you got to put people in positions where they can prosper, where they're going to be challenged. And these people stepped up to the challenge and did their thing. So I'm excited.
It worked out. And definitely. Now, question, because you said you took it from 176 pages to 96 pages.
174 to 93.
How is it as a writer cutting your material down? Because I know sometimes, you know, you could be to that point where you just don't want to let anything go, but you kind of have to because you have those time restraints. So how was that for you?
Well, I was at that point. It was bad to see things go. And even as we filmed the 93 pages, some of it got cut because there's a lot of stuff that you just can't film.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Martinique's over there hungry. How can we film that? Baby was over there passing gas. How can we, you know what I mean? I could write that on paper, but there's no way to film it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So had to get rid of a lot of unfilmable stuff. Yeah. You know? So it's
probably for the best they kept that part out.
Right.
I got an image to maintain. Yeah, exactly. I got an image now.
So yeah, you don't want to be up there farting on camera.
You got the sound effects. You could have made it happen if you really wanted to, but it wasn't necessary.
It was rough seeing stuff go, but it was great to see people get the words and still ad lib. Mm-hmm. I was giving them freedom to say, you know what, if this feels better to you and you want to flip it, let's make it work. Yeah. You have to make a great film. You know what I mean? I don't want to get caught up in, I wrote that, you got to do that, you got to say that.
Yeah.
It might not come out natural. It might not feel real to the actor. You mm-hmm. know what I mean? So I want them as comfortable as possible so they can deliver and we can put forth a great, great movie. And these guys embodied that and they did that.
It was the little things, too, that made it mm-hmm. that way for us. Like, you know, instead of calling my father, yeah. we were like, daddy. You know, because that's just what we do, right?
Right.
It's just the little things. And he allowed us to do that. And that is rare.
So right.
It's really rare.
It was bringing the offset, like, daddy.
Yeah. 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 Daddy. Oh, man. You know, it really gave us room to grow, you know, and that freedom is what allows us to do great work, too.
So how quickly did you guys build the chemistry as a cast?
Well, I think...
We had our lunch break.
Yep. Yeah, we got some Popeye's chicken and it was good.
Popeye's was good. That's what they say. You know.
He's sitting on our lap. You know, we...
As soon as you get a wing and a biscuit...
That's it. You know, but honestly, you know, we all just... We had the same goal in mind. Mm-hmm. So it was easy to gel. Everybody wanted to make the best work possible. And that's what really made us excel. Yeah. Like, we wanted to challenge each other to be great
at the end of the day,
as artists.
You guys, you know, as a collective, if everybody as an individual looks good and does their best, then you're going to have a great movie as a whole. So I can understand how you guys just click like that over some Popeye's chicken and a good script.
We really became family. Like, we were fussing and you know, fighting and laughing. Yeah, you know, we had our moments.
Who ate the last piece of chicken?
Yeah, exactly.
Who was it?
Bryce.
Daddy.
Everybody. You know what? I like the fact that we bonded really well from every actor, small. Yeah. There was no small parts. Everybody had a huge part in the production, and everybody was treated the same. Like, there was no, oh no, wait for my lights, I gotta get my close up. It was none of that. We were all grinding. We did those hours. We took, you know, we did our thing, and it was no Hollywood attitudes, because when you're in this game, you have to be able to grind it out, and everything is not gonna work the way you plan it, but it's gonna work the way it's planned.
Yeah, I like that.
I like that.
Yeah, definitely do. Now, was it, because I know everything wasn't all, you know, peaches and cream when it said no. Was there any kind of difficult, you know, for you, anything difficult getting the movie shot and done?
Well, it wasn't no difficulty. We had what you say? I tell you, don't talk about that in public, right?
She missed the first half of the show when we were talking about, you know, taping conversations and whatnot.
Next week on How to Not Be in a Sequel. Lorraine Martin. Starring I've Been Cut.
We kept the mic off of her for that one.
Right, right. It was definitely some difficult times, but there's going to be challenges. Mm. You know, one of the directors, Ernest Robinson, was our first time working together. It was the first time working with the group. Mm-hmm. And there was a slight advantage because I worked with everybody before, so they pretty much knew how I worked. You know, we could laugh and joke at 8:57, 9:01. They'd be like, yo, what's wrong with Jermaine?
Yeah, it's time.
You know what I mean? It's showtime. It's time to get busy. You know what I mean? So, but we had some good times and we had some bad times and we had some scenes that dragged on, you know, so, but it happens on every set. You know what I mean? So people brought their A game, and then my thing is, if you don't have your A game that day, just give us the best you can that day, you know, and we'll be all right.
Now, you had the triple threat, book, play, movie. You want to go for the quad and make a TV series?
Well, working on something else as a TV series, but you know what? If someone loves the movie and says, you know what, this thing needs to go into the TV realm, that's great. You know what I mean? My thing, as long as I can have some type of creative control, you know, you want to bring back your cash, you want to bring back this. I mean, I had a wish list for this movie, but Hollywood wasn't answering me for 2 years. So shoot it myself, get the people I want to work with, and no one can tell me how long the movie's going to be. No one can tell me who to cast. No one can tell me, look, you got to cut that person. You know what I mean? So if they're showing the love, you know, you can work with who you can. But if someone comes and say, okay, we want to do something as a TV series, then, you know, you definitely want to talk creative control because you want to use the same people. You want to go with the same people. You know what I mean?
And you want to add me to it.
Yeah, definitely. You know what I mean? Hey, you got to have the right skin tone.
That man is
going to
get him a part in this
movie.
That's right. We need our token.
In the sequel.
Somebody got to go on the poster. Got
to fit the quota.
Yeah. Listen, get him a role, please, because I've been trying to, you know, get his acting career started. I'm trying to help him out.
Well,
push him,
I am going to be filming tomorrow in an upcoming movie, so that's, you know.
That's what's up.
Okay, congratulations.
A streamlined production. I'll keep everyone posted. It's a major role in there, so
okay.
I play the villain though, so you know, I'm usually usually the good guy, the baby face nice guy, but now I'm the you know, yeah.
There you go.
Yeah, definitely. Hey, Denzel got his Oscar for Training Day, so
yes. True.
You know, he definitely
just have to bum rush a spot. Yep.
There you go. Exactly. This is true. Congratulations on that though.
Thank you.
That's a good look.
Really quick, tell the people your Instagram and where they can follow the movie at on Instagram.
The movie is A Piece of Me the Movie. That's APCOFTHE movie. That's on Instagram and Twitter. On Instagram, Everyday the Brand. That's Everyday, TheBrand. On Twitter, it's Everyday, DaBrand. And you can follow me, get all the information about the movie and everything we got going on, Twitter and Instagram.
And let me tell you this at home, all right? Because next week is the premiere. We're going to be in the building. If I see anybody with their cameras, don't be trying to bootleg this movie. All right? Because I know how y'all do out there. Don't come up here with no cameras in the theater trying to bootleg stuff. You buy your ticket and you sit down and watch the movie, and that's where, you know, everybody going to have a good time. All right?
Make and sure that goes to my family members, sure too. They be the ones bootlegging.
Yep. See, because like, well, we family, so I can get this on tape now. I can do this.
Selling at the family reunion.
$5.99.
What is this, man? Y'all up here bootlegging my movie? Come on, man.
And the funny part, they have Statman face instead of Steve as the villain.
Yep.
You gonna change white guys.
Exactly.
Yep, coming up.
You gotta be quick.
Gotta go corporate.
Exactly. They'll get you on that one. But we definitely gotta move on with the program a little bit. We're gonna keep the guys out here for a little while, but we do gotta get to Ladybug. And myself and Statman, we were at another charity event. Y'all know we love the kids, we support the kids, with Anthony Mason Jr. This past week, and we were at his charity event over at Contra Studios in Manhattan for his Family on Three charity. It was a great event. Statman got to chop it up with a couple of people. We did some interviews and whatnot. So we're going to show you guys a little bit of that Family on Three charity and what they have cooking up. They got a lot of events coming up soon, too. So we're going to jump into that video really quick. And when we come back, we're going to have more with the cast, more with Jermaine, and we're going to have Ladybug on the set with us. So if you guys would.
So you Family on Three in here, but you Family on Three when you walking outside. You Family on Three on your own when you're inside.
They said that
same hard work you got bringing in here, bring that in everything you do. Hands up, Family on Three. 1, 2, 3.
Family! Y'all, what's up, Brian? And I want to give a shout out to my boy, Ant Mace Jr. and the Family on Three program. If you have a goal, stick to it and try to achieve it. Work your hardest to do so.
Yes, it's your main man, M-E-Z, Power 105 on his own. Shout out to my guy, Anthony Mason Jr. and Family on Three. Something for the kids. We're doing it for the community. I love the kids. So does Anthony Mason Jr. We're doing it for the kids. Family on Three.
This is for the kids. Stay motivated. Keep doing your thing. Dream big. Always dream big. Family on Three. 1, 2, 3. Family. It's Nicky A.B. Holla.
Good luck during the year. Have a good year. Get after the grades.
Priscilla Hendrick here, professional track and field athlete for the country of Antigua and Barbuda in training for 2016 Olympic Games this summer. I want to give a huge shout out to Family on Three and for all the kids out there, always be the best version of yourself.
Family on Three, baby. You know what I'm saying? I'm pitching to excel, like, on all skills. You know, basketball and sports open so many doors, so you got to prepare these kids, you know, for other aspects of that. When those doors open, the business aspects, the brand aspects, the accountability, the professionalism, you know? And that's all that Family on Three is about. That's why it's called family. That's what you do at home, so let's do it here.
With Ladybug and Trip Young on the award-winning TV show Real Fans, Real Talk. I want to tell you kids out there, follow your dreams. You can do anything if you put your mind to it. That's not just a saying. It's real life. It's Family on Three.
What up, y'all? It's your boy, Freddie Garson, a.k.a. Goldo. All the kids out there, stay, keep your heads in the books. Stay out of trouble. Stay out of trouble. Stay off the streets.
Alright, what's up, it's Taj Gibson and Family on Three. Shout out to all the kids. Keep believing in yourself. Anything is possible.
It's Curtis Kelly. Shout out to the whole Family on Three and the Family on Three movement. To the kids, I just want to say work hard, keep your circle together, and always keep God first.
Movies now.
You stay delicate.
Be big time now. You don't got to take that from nobody.
Exactly. You got to stop. Hey.
We are back, ladies and gentlemen. Real Fans, Real Talk. Mark the Statman Skevich alongside my co-host Trip Young and the one and only Ladybug is back on the program. And we got, the cast of the Piece of Me movie joining us. Of course, Instagram, APC of Me, the movie. Make sure you check them out. You can buy your tickets. The link for the to buy your tickets is right there on Instagram. So make sure you follow them on Instagram or click the link to get your tickets. Not many left, so make sure you pick them up. But without further ado, we have the Rumor Mill and the one and only Ladybug. What's going on, Ladybug?
What's going on? You know, every week I got to come with a new... What's going on, Trip?
Hey, what's
Trip
going on?
Loves when I'm on. Yo, like, no, he cannot hide his excitement.
Because, you know, because we was out last night, we were supporting H2O. He had another music showcase. And every time, you know, we go outside to events, Ladybug and myself seem to get in trouble. So I'm just glad that everything is okay. Everything
I'm not
cool.
Surprised. That's why I didn't come through this time.
Rumors. We did not get in trouble. We had a fun night.
We may or may not have got kicked out the venue, but it's okay. I'm not going to put that out there just yet.
And you know what? Let's start the rumor mill. Hope everybody's doing well. Shout out to my favorite, Reese and Mercedes. You know, I always got to say hi to you guys every week. But let me start off with this tip. This whole Kyrie Irving and this singer Kalani, basically, you know, there was this whole fiasco going on because on social media, there was a picture of Kalani. Mind you, she's an up-and-coming artist. She has great songs, great features. You know, her project's really dope. You know, she's up-and-coming, and she was rumored to be with Kyrie Irving. They had a little bit, you know, something happening for a little bit, and... she was technically posted up in a picture with another artist named Party Next Door. Now, this started and sparked the whole fiasco, like, oh my gosh, she's doing stuff on the low, she's being dirty, how can she do it? The memes were going on, like, this man is worth all this money, he's still getting cheated on, so what about you? Just had a lot of people questioning themselves.
Wait, so you're saying it's better to be broke, because then if you get cheated on...
I'm just saying, no, it's just saying, like, he has money and he's getting cheated on, you probably have no chance. You know, so that's basically...
First of all, I'm wiped up. Me and Serena...
Now he's taking it personal.
I don't want to say...
Listen, all right. This is what I'm saying.
My wifey boo Serena is at home. She take good care of me.
That's what she tells you. That's what she tells you.
Go ahead. That's what makes you go to sleep at night. Go ahead, Trip. But yeah,
she made me go to
sleep
at night.
So then, you know, but then it, on a serious note, the singer Kalani, she was posted up in the hospital and, you know, they were saying that she attempted suicide and that's a very serious thing. And they were saying that, you know, she was trying to grab attention because of the whole, you know, breakup and her doing her thing. And it actually that it was shown that Kyrie Irving made a statement and said, when this picture was posted, we weren't even together. So this shows how quick social media can misconstrue mm-hmm. something. Mm-hmm. And like you say, a picture, you know, means a thousand words, but every word is not the right word. So, you know, on a serious note, we had to pray for her because that's a serious thing. You know, suicide in any form, any matter is just something that's very serious. It's not talked about, but it's very serious. But for, you know, for social media to say that she's doing it for attention or to, you know, distract the fact that she was doing whatever she was doing, and even Kyrie Irving saying that they weren't together, it just made a situation just very, you know, uncomfortable. So, you know, on that note, my prayers go out to her, and just stay out of people's business. Like, you know, you have friends doing that too. You're not sitting there going on social media. But anyway, on another note, had to go on to UFC star John Jones. He was arrested for violating his probation for racing. Like, you know, car issues. Come on, UFC, you making all this money and you have to turn yourself in because you drag racing? Really?
I mean,
really? Come on! He all that out. Money you want to drag race? On that one. Close off a driving thing and go race in a regular track, like.
Well, the adrenaline junkies, you know. Yeah, like, I mean, like, that's why they're fighting in the first place. You know,
five times he got caught up, and they were just like, you know what? Just turn yourself in. Like, we paying you for what? Like, what are you doing? You blowing all this money. We give you this money to fight, and you're blowing it all. So he turned himself in. So I hope that. That gets off.
I'm an adrenaline junkie too. I'm out there drag racing.
Not in the car. Like
that movie, that commercial with those guys escaping the cops in the Prius.
That man don't need nobody to take his indiscretions because he's just gonna put it all out there. So
I don't get caught when I drag race though.
No, Stat.
They're gonna be looking for you now. See, good job.
You did it to yourself. But yeah, so on to the next one. You know, Lamar Odom. In the Kardashian clan. You know, when you bring the Kardashians, it can't be just one. It has to be everybody. So, you know, he was spotted with Khloe Kardashian, you know, for Easter. You know, he was with the family. And, you know, just supporting. We don't know what happens. It's always social media switching something up. But now they're saying that Khloe's trying to push Lamar to go back to rehab and, you know, get himself together. But he's not going. So now social media saying, well, maybe she wants him to go because she wants another spinoff and she wants all the cameras to catch his recovery. They just trying to make a check. And then some people are saying, you know, maybe they're trying to make the marriage work. Maybe she's just really trying to genuinely be there for him. But, you know, that Kardashian curse, when you see them, you see cameras. And a lot of people don't like to trust their personal lives with them.
And so, she's still messing with French Montana?
That's still his bae. He seen her in that Nike Nike outfit. He was like, that's still bae. So we don't know what happens. But
I would hope that she's genuinely wanting him to go to rehab and not doing that for no show or for no check. Because, you know, we all saw what happened with Lamar Odom. And
serious.
It was not a good look. So I really hope for his sake. I hope he does go to rehab. And for the right reason, I hope he does continue to get better because I know he's been out drinking and whatnot. It's probably dealing, you know, with her and she messing with everything moving and what. I'm sorry.
Chip Young said that. You see, that was Chip Young and that was different. But
you,
no.
You have a near-death experience and that should be like the enough motivation as it is to go out there and fix yourself. But at the same time, you know, like Trip said, it could be her messing with his mind or whatever, but you can't put the blame on anyone really but yourself in that situation. But yeah. I don't, you know, he could go to rehab without it being filmed too. So it
and
doesn't.
That's what I hope. You know, I think
that's, you know, the more likely scenario. I think a real rehab facility should say, hey, you know, he doesn't need this part of the rehab and in his life. Like, you know, I don't think, you know.
But Kardashians have their ways. That's all. I'm just gonna leave that on. Yeah. They have their ways
of messing up people's lives. But, I mean, I'm sorry, go ahead.
Anyway, you know
what? Oh, my bad.
I know, views and Chip, yeah. I know, right?
Yeah. Kim might be in the sequel. Kim might be in the sequel. Kim got a movie out already.
What happened to everyone that dealt with the Kardashians, Jenner, Humphries, you know, everybody, Lamar Odom, and say they can't wait to see what they do to Kanye. They did it to him already. I mean,
nah, I think Kanye was his Kanye own level. And they was like, they had to step back. Like, we can't get on his bad side.
$10 million he's supposed to be paying Amber Rose to not let the cat out the bag on his indiscretions says it all with
Mama
Kanye.
Got
he
that.
Was messed up long before he
that's
got
that's why he need that. What is it, $53
billion? Yeah.
Tragedy, that whole story. Ray J's not getting a dime out of all this.
Oh, that's sad, man.
See, like everybody said, oh, you right.
Yeah, that's messed up. I thought Ray J was getting half. You got to get half of that at least. You know? Somebody got to get a lawyer in there or something. Because he's supposed to be getting money
for
that.
I think that, that's
good. If you do those things, see, people can't use things against you.
If you own it. If somebody said he saw
you doing something, say, yeah.
And what? Because the minute you let that get to you, that power over you, it can eat you alive. Yeah, like, if you caught, you know, shout out to Kanye. If that's what you like, boo, do you, right?
Well, I'm not going to condone the
listen, you know what? Listen. Whatever that man want to do, that's his business.
It's going to be playing right after the piece of me go on.
Well, no.
Wait, hold on. Wait a minute, because we still got Bryce Jr. on the set.
Oh, all right,
you know, we have been getting here grown folk conversations.
Oh, that's right.
We had to bring him back on the set because we don't know if you guys, it's a school night in the morning. You got school tomorrow?
Mm. Yes.
What class you got tomorrow, first thing in the morning?
I got reading.
Reading? All right, yeah, we need you to be
you
well
keep your eyes open. Yeah, you need it.
All right, so that's why we got you on the set now. We're gonna let you right now just get your final thought in right now because while it's still early. So whatever you want to say about the movie or about your next performance, what you got coming up, you can say it now. And look at the camera. That's your camera right up there.
Go ahead.
Well, I was happy that I did my first movie with Jermaine and that's
right.
About it.
All right, well, there we go. That's all I did. He's happy to be in the movie. Are you looking forward to the sequel?
Yeah.
All right. So he's going to be in the sequel, and then everybody else, please get Statman in the sequel. Please. Like,
Or the TV series.
We're going to start a petition. Get Statman in the movies.
So all
right,
fun.
Hashtag that, please. Somebody get that trending on Twitter right now. Get Statman in the movies. All right.
There we go.
You got the cast pulling for you. Oh, you want to give them your Instagram?
Oh, yes.
Go ahead.
All right, before I get out of here, I just want y'all to know that Cotton Candy, I'm known as Cotton Candy in a different element, but for this, from the Air It Out show. From the Air It Out show, no dancing or anything like that. I'm just Cotton Candy because I'm sweet until you make me mad and then it's a different story. But you can follow our business Instagram at Air It Out Show, one word. It's Air It Out Show, one word. And the team will definitely, you know, let you guys know how to reach me. I don't have Instagram yet, but one day soon, when I learn how to disable those DMs, because it be going down and I'm not ready.
Oh, my.
She's trying to prep herself. Yeah. Yes. I respect it.
She owning it before it even comes out there. Whatever was in them DMs, she's owning it now.
Right.
So if it get out, hey, if it's get screenshotted, all right. Angela,
we are not reciting no lines right now.
Wow.
Exactly. Definitely goes down. Well, Ladybug, is that it? You got anything else for us?
No, that's my wrap up for the week. You know, stay tuned. Follow me on my personal page. You already know I keep you guys locked throughout the week and make sure you tune in every Thursday for me.
That's right.
For me, like I said.
Dang, you know
the fans get crazy when
they
I don't.
Do, they
that
do.
First
they
that
do.
First 30 minutes, I'm getting
yeah.
up. So you're not
they
on.
They do blow up the feed and,
it's
and
real.
Whatnot. We don't need.
I love you guys.
Come
you guys
in.
Are awesome. You make me come in. I love it.
Oh my goodness.
And you're very humble about the on deck was, you know, Ladybug.
No, because you guys get me all the time, so now I have to say my shine.
But yours, you're the. You know, you're Ladybug _2.0, so maybe she's the real Ladybug.
Nah, you know what's crazy? You know, that's her old name. You see? Statman just gave a throwback Thursday. That's not even my Instagram
exactly.
name no
that
more.
The,
that was
the old underscores.
Yeah, just okay. Ladybug.
Exactly.
Fill in the blank.
That was in the DM, fill in the blank.
Get him. Trip. Y'all been on the road today.
We're going to be next Thursday.
Because I'm there next Thursday, too.
Next Thursday, we are going to be at the theaters. and we're going to be in London.
Make
and
sure you don't sit next to Trip Young. He talks through the movie.
Stop hating. Okay, you're going to stop hating, right? I don't talk through the movie, all right? But I will have some nachos while I'm at the movie theaters, and it's going to be all love. It's going to be a family affair. Ladybug.
I love you,
you know what? See, this is why you always in trouble. Because of reasons like this, we're not even going to talk about those things right now. We're talking about a piece of me, the movie. So make sure y'all get your tickets. Jake, can you tell them the Eventbrite page and all that so that if they haven't already?
Yeah, it's www.eventbrite.com. You can search a piece of me. And I'm telling you on camera right now, they just said they got kicked out of somewhere last night, so I will kick them out next week. Y'all not going to mess up my moment. I'm sorry.
That's a rumor.
It'll be just me and Mark.
Well, I left on my own. Ladybug got kicked out. I just don't want to, you know, throw under the bus like that, but since the tape's out, it's out. You know, it's all good.
No, wait till this show go. Make sure you follow our Instagram page so you can see what happens after the show.
Exactly, because it's about to go down. And then once again, you guys make sure you get those tickets and come out next week. There's going to be a lot of celebrities at that theater. It's all about a piece of me, the movie. You see, we brought y'all the cast. We brought y'all the director, the writer, producer, the driver, the cameraman. We make the lunch, you do the catering and all that. Everything we bought y'all. And then, yeah, man, it's all about the theaters next week, Stat, man. You ready for this?
Definitely ready.
Let's get to it. It's all about a piece of me, the movie. And make sure you guys stay locked in. We're not going to be live next week because we're going to be at the theaters. But make sure you check us out on the web, realfansrealtalk.com, Twitter, Instagram, at realfantalk. YouTube is youtube.com/forthefansproductions and facebook.com/realfansrealtalk. Oh, if you got fan mail questions for us, send them in fanmail@realfansrealtalk.com and we will be more than happy to get to those topics.
And you know, we didn't, you know, I think we brushed on it earlier, but we nominated, and you know, the Be Free Awards is this Saturday. So, you know, I just have to tell people to vote. Definitely, I have the link on my Instagram. It's in the bio. One like equals a vote. So definitely like the video and
Do the real vote. Don't do like other people doing, try to go out there and buy your votes. We don't do that here on Real Fans Real Talk.
Oh, yeah.
We
get ours homegrown because the fans really love us. Nice. Don't do that.
And
don't
we're nominated for People's Choice, so definitely everybody like it. And you're going to see what happens because you already know if our name gets called, I'm going crazy on social media. I'm making my own memes, so it's okay. It's going to happen.
Going up there like ODB at the Grammys.
No, I'm pulling a Kanye. Like, oh, I think Real Fans Real Talk
yep. Exactly. It is.
And we all right.
There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Make sure you check out A Piece of Me movie. Like to thank the cast for joining us here on Real Fans Real Talk. Of course, Trip Young and Ladybug, as always. I'm Mark the Stat Manskevich. Thank you all for joining us. Jay, I want to see you in blue next time you're on the show. No more of that Flyers. Go Rangers. And thank you again for joining us. Real Fans Real Talk. We'll see you next time, everyone. Have a good night.
Good night.
Like just, okay, vote now and vote for everybody else never.
Face facts, what up? RealFansRealTalk.com. Where Arthur Domus, Trip Young, and intern Tom. For the white and black fans, Asia to Manhattan. I get all my facts from my bro, Mark the Stats Man. If you're not tuned in, I recommend a CAT scan. And if your brain checks out, then you deserve a backhand. Sports, gossip, all the hot topics. RealFansRealTalk.com got it. They got the hottest bloggers.
Did Jeremy Lin hurt?
We'll log onto the site and you can hear it from them first. I'm talking about the latest. I'm talking about the greatest. Go check out the archives. Even tell a neighbor. Tell them Bobby sent ya. From spring to winter, tuning in should be the only...